welcome to this virtual service, a Christmas blessing from the churches and people of Bishop Auckland to everyone in Bishop Auckland. Celebrations have had to be different this year, but 2020 has brought us closer together by our shared circumstances and care for one another. Whether we have been able to see one another socially distanced, in person, or online, on Facebook or other means. During this service, I hope you will recognize representatives from our town's businesses, charities, Facebook groups, community hubs, and churches. They share what Christmas means to them. We have readings, dramatic dance, and carols about the birth of Jesus, the reason for Christmas. We have scenes of our town painted by local artist Eric Thompson. The Bishop of Durham gives us a Christmas message and his blessing from St. Peter's Chapel in Auckland Castle. As a town, Christmas this year is themed around bells. Well, our town has a new discovery. The Bishop's Bell inside Robinson's Arch Gateway to Auckland Castle. It is an ancient bell of substance and historical significance. So it is especially appropriate that Jonathan Ruffer reads from Lord Tennyson's poem, Wild Bells. In a year that we can now look back on, we ring out the past. At Christmas time, we ring with joy that God came among us as Jesus Christ, our eternal hope. And we ring in the new as we look ahead to 2021. Let us begin with a prayer led by Father Dennis.
All of all life, people who love do crazy things, and you are total love. We thank you for the reckless, costly love you have for each of us. You became vulnerable for our sake, asking a teenage girl to be the mother of your son, to share her life with him, to care for and nurture him, and with a young mother's love give him to the world, and ache with grief in his suffering and death. Jesus shared humanity's joys and sorrows, and freed us from sin and darkness. We humbly and inadequately thank you in this time of preparing to celebrate his birth and waiting in longing for his second coming to unite all creation in himself. Father, we give thanks today and forever. Amen.
But you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. Therefore Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labour bears a son, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth. And he will be our peace. When the Assyrians invade our land and march through our fortresses, we will raise against them 7 shepherds, even 8 commanders.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great.
Answer a couple of questions from Eileen, and I think the question is, what does Christmas mean? This year is a bit different through personal situation. I operate with a team of great individuals, some fantastic bars. And what is a bar to me? A bar is all about your regional social interaction, and at Christmas time that becomes very, very important. But this year is a bit different through a personal situation with my family. I think my belief in Christmas this year has changed slightly. I think it's more about the real meaning of Christmas. The real meaning of Christmas for me this year is becoming ever more important, and it's about loved ones. It's about family, dear friends, people. And I think what I'd like to say to people this Christmas is value them. Beyond belief, they'll be the most important thing in your life.
Hello, I'm Gary from Inspiral Cycles in Bishop Auckland.
Hello, I'm Fiona from Inspiral Cycles, and we both live in Bishop Auckland.
Fiona, what does Christmas mean to you?
Christmas, for me, has always meant a celebration of birthdays. We can all share some image of the birthday of Jesus and the Nativity scene, but for me, Christmas Day is also my mum's birthday. This is Veronica on her 94th birthday last Christmas. She was one of the shop's biggest fans. Although she couldn't ride a bike, she kept fairly fit, riding an exercise bike in the gym twice a week. Sadly, she died with COVID in May, 8 weeks after her care home first went into lockdown. I'll light a birthday candle for her this Christmas. and pray for all our families who are separated this Christmas in contrast to previous years. We can focus back on the nativity scene with a family in far from ideal surroundings. Let's celebrate a new life, a new start in difficult circumstances. And Christmas will always mean, to me, going to midnight mass, then lighting a birthday candle, pulling a cracker and wearing a silly hat. Gary, what are your hopes for this Christmas?
Right. Thank you, Fiona. It's been a very challenging year and all our lives have changed. There's been a fair amount of talk and increased awareness of mental health and that we actually need to do something to keep ourselves healthy in mind and body. Even if it's just going out for some fresh air now and again or cutting down on the booze. So my hope for the next year or for Christmas is that wherever we've made positive changes to our lives, we're able to continue and build on that. Also, once we're able to socialise again, I hope that new healthier habits can even become contagious.
What Christmas means to me is celebrating the birth of Jesus, and also it's about family.
I would second that it's all about family with me, having my children and my partner with me, as this year has shown us that's what we need at this time of year even more.
Yeah, I think like Anne says, this year for Christmas, I hope that everybody remains safe. They all have some form of company, that nobody is left in total isolation alone. And I wish everybody peace and love.
Once again, second that, it shows you that we're all on the same wavelength, that everyone stays safe and manages to have some sort of company in any which way, shape or form, whether it's in person, by Zoom, on the telephone, and everybody just tries to enjoy Christmas as usual, but in a completely different way this year.
For me, it's about every single, you know, person hopefully, you know, keeping connected with their families, with their friends this Christmas. And it's just that nice way to sort of give back and have that really nice family time.
Definitely a lot of toasting over Skype, maybe a sneaky little tipple, but it will just be, as you know, trying to get as much family time as we can, considering how long the distance is.
And that's the thing, and I think, you know, what you've just kind of led on to there is, what do we want for Christmas? What do we want out of this Christmas? And I think for me, it's going to be, you know, making sure we stay connected. I mean,
definitely.
We started the COVID group to keep connected.
Definitely. I mean, that's why every day I try and, you know, touch base with everybody, because I think some people, I might be the only person who's talked to them all day.
Yeah.
So I try and just make sure everyone's okay. We try and pick up and see, you know, if somebody's saying they're not having a good time, we try and touch base with them and see if there's anything we can do. We've had people who've said they're worried about their finances, so, you know, we've private messaged them and said, is there anything we can do to help? And that's really why you set up a group.
Why we, you know, manage it, you know, the rest of the administrators. I mean, obviously from the start it was about connection, it was connection for, you know, people who didn't have that support network back in March, to actually connect to, you know, outside other people to get that support, whether it be, you know, keeping our carers, who a lot of them had to shield and self-isolate, keeping them connected with the Cups for Care package, which you, you know, wonderfully came up with Morrison's, when I spoke with Julie Knighton, the community organiser there, to keep the food banks connected with their, you know, weekly supplies. So for me, it's about every single, you know, person, hopefully, you know, keeping connected with their families, with their friends this Christmas.
Definitely. I mean, we ended up with 35 care homes that we helped with Cups for Carers, and 7 different hospitals. And even like this week, we're helping people who are struggling. So we've kind of found, you know, we found parcels from the food bank, you know, Christmas hampers, you know, help with fuel allowance, all these different things that people may take for granted when they're not in this situation. And then suddenly the situation is hit, and people who've never needed help before feel pride and they're like, oh, I can't ask for help. And we're like, but that's what help's there for. That's why we do this. It's to help people who don't necessarily know how to access the help.
Christmas to Angel Trust is a very, very, very busy time. We give a lot of toys out at Christmas over the toy appeal. We'll deliver to over 2,000 families. We go out to the children's wards, the children's hospices, and we deliver all of the gifts tailored to those families. It's a big team effort. This year, we've had to adapt with what's happened, and we're doing a lot of food hampers every week. So we've got a big plan for food hampers throughout Christmas. We also are going to be delivering hampers and to all of the carers in our area, the NHS, the GP surgeries, to say thank you for what they've done this year. It's been a year like no other, and I really hope and pray this Christmas that it does change. Angel Trust is about raising money from the local community and giving it back out to the community. And this year we haven't been able to hold our events and raise the huge funds what we do, and we haven't been able to give out the funds what we generate from the income. So I really hope it changes next year and we can raise a lot of funds from the local community to give back out to the people in need in our community. I'd like to wish everybody a happy Christmas and a healthy and happy new year, especially my family and my loved ones. Also my Angel Trust family. We are a family and we're very, very close. The trustees, the volunteers, everybody who helps us at Angel Trust, and there is a huge amount, and I really appreciate all what you do. Thank you so much. And again, all the families and all of the people that we've helped throughout this year, I'd like to also wish you a very, very Merry Christmas, and we're always here for you.
Out wild bells to the wild sky, the flying cloud, the frosty light. The year is dying in the night. Ring out wild bells and let him die. Ring out the old, ring in the new. Ring happy bells across the snow. The year is going, let him go. Ring out the false. Ring in the true. Ring out the grief that saps the mind, for those that hear we see no more. Ring out the feud of rich and poor. Ring in redress to all mankind. Ring out a slowly dying cause and ancient forms of party strife. Ring in the nobler modes of life, with sweeter manners, purer laws. Ring out the want, the care, the sin, the faithless coldness of the times. Ring out my mournful rhymes, but ring the fuller minstrel in. ring out false pride in place and blood, the civic slander and the spite. Ring in the love of truth and right. Ring in the common love of good. Ring out old shapes of foul disease. Ring out the narrowing lust of gold. Ring out the thousand wars of old. Ring in the thousand years of peace. Ring in the valiant man and free, the larger heart, the kindlier hand. Ring out the darkness of the land. Ring in the Christ that is to be.
Verses 1 to 18. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that the whole world should be registered. This was the first registration that was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their towns to be registered. Joseph went to the town of Nazareth in Galilee, Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in the manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood by them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for the people. To you is born this day the city of David, a Saviour, who is Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you, and you will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was an angel, a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those who he favors." When the angels had left them and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Now let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them.
It's been fabulous having people from around the community sharing with us through this service. And hasn't it been brilliant the way that the community of Bishop Auckland has come together through the last months to support and encourage and help one another? We should pat ourselves on the back for being committed to serving well as a community and being a good community. This Christmas, I think community matters more than ever. And I want to highlight the fact that community was really important for the first Christmas story. This community in Bethlehem had been expanded because the government of the day, very different from our government, had made people go there to register. So there was a buzz around the place. It wasn't a hugely positive buzz. They were overcrowded because the government had made people go there. But it was a community. And there were Joseph and pregnant Mary in the midst of it. They'd been forced to go by government action. Very different from what we face. But this year, we've been involved with having to do things as a community, as a nation, because of government guidance. And then, in the midst of that, Jesus is born. And that news goes to the shepherds. The shepherds race down. They find the baby as the angels have promised. They share their story with Joseph and Mary. And no doubt Joseph and Mary shared with the shepherds the story of their son and how he had come to be born. And then we read a verse that often people don't hear read with this Christmas story. That afterwards, the shepherds went out to the community to tell them the good news that their Saviour had been born. They shared good news with the community. A community that was struggling with not such good news was now hearing good news. That God was acting. That God's love was in action for them. That the long-promised Saviour had been born. So we want to be a community that has had restrictions, has had difficulties that we've struggled with, but we also want to be a community that hears good news. Good news from one another. Good news from local businesses, local community groups. And there's lots of that good news around. But I want to remind us all this Christmas that the best good news for the community is that God is alive, that God loves us, that God cares for us, and that that is discovered in the baby who was born in Bethlehem, in Jesus, who of course grew up and then was crucified and rose again. But we have good news for Bishop Auckland this Christmas. May we as a community rejoice in good news. So this Christmas, may the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be ours personally and as a community. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and upon Bishop Auckland this Christmas and always. Amen.